Assalamualaikum, grade 4. So today we meet again, and then we still learn about after school, which is we talk about the agenda, days, and also the adverb of frequency. Last week, Miss Sulis already gave you the lesson about days and also about how you fill up your agenda. Okay. Today we learn more deeper about the adverb of frequency and also the use of go plus verb ing. Okay, welcome all grade 4. Nah, we still talk about the starter 2 after school. Okay, here you will learn about days, schedule and time of frequency. Okay, schedule and agenda. You will see your agenda in your book. That one is the sample of the agenda. So the schedule is time that you manage on doing something. We need adverb of frequency and days to make our schedule. Agenda is the fixed schedule that you've made, so others will know your free time or your busy time. Jadi kalau schedule itu adalah masih dalam bentuk rencana gitu ya. Jadi saya hari Senin mau main ini, saya hari Selasa mau punya activity ini, hari Rabu mau kesini, hari Kamis, itu merupakan schedule, jadwal acara, oke? Okay? Atau bisa dibilangnya weekly plan, rencana. Nah kalau agenda, semua yang sudah teman-teman rencanakan itu you write on your book. Ditulis di buku. Hari Kamis mau main ke rumahnya Miss Sulis. Hari Senin mau makan bakso sama mama. Hari Selasa mau go shopping sama ayah. Hari Rabu, nah itu namanya agenda. Kan sudah ditulis di buku. Oke, jadi tahu ya, you know the difference between schedule and agenda. Jadi harus tahu dulu nih bedanya. Jangan bingung. Oke, next. Ini samplesnya, ini contohnya beberapa agenda yang udah jadi. Jadi punyanya apa? Ada yang namanya go swimming hari Senin, Selasanya nanti teman-teman bisa dengerin di audionya. Hari Rabunya ada play badminton. Nah, kalau punyanya Pams, dia hari Senin berenang, hari Selasa main tenis, hari Rabu main skating, ya. Nah, punyanya Joe, hari Kamis dia main basket, hari Jumatnya dia free. Ternyata hari Sabtunya dia habis main baseball, terus dia berenang. Nah, ini agenda, karena sudah ada di buku, sudah ditulis. Oke, okay? Next. Let's see.
Oh.
Okay, next, this one is the sample of agenda. More ya, before kan you already see the sample, and is this one also the sample of the agenda. Jadi ingat, kalau schedule masih direncanain, masih rencana, agenda sudah ditulis di buku. Nah, sekarang kita ngomongin adverb of frequency. Adverb of frequency itu yang sering kita pakai kalau kita mau bikin agenda. Ada always, ada sometimes, ada never gitu ya. Nah, nih di buku teman-teman you will see also the use, how to use the adverb of frequency. Ada how often. Often itu juga termasuk adverb of frequency. Apa sih adverb of frequency? Itu adalah menanyakan waktunya, berapa lama, berapa sering, gitu kan? Let's see this video. Okay, so you will find the adverb of frequency.
Adverbs of frequency are used to talk about how frequently you do something or something happens. In a sentence, they come after the verb to be, or before other verbs. day comes at the end of the sentence.
Okay, so that one is adverb of frequency. Next. Oke, okay. Tadi kita sudah ada yang namanya always, sometimes. Terus hati-hati dengan penggunaan ada time-nya, every day gitu ya. Itu kita pakainya di mana? Sekarang, next. Nah, sekarang kita belajar lagi yang namanya go verb ing. Teman-teman akan nemuin di buku ada yang namanya go skating, go swimming gitu ya. Itu apa sih? Nah, go verb ing ini biasanya kita pakai kalau kita mau menjelaskan activity atau kegiatan kita di luar. Biasanya kita ngomongin pakai go plus verb ing itu kalau kita ngomongin outdoor activity. Tapi ada juga kalau kita mau ngomongin kebiasaan kita. Jadi go plus verb ing ini ngomongin hobi atau kesukaan atau kebiasaan. Di kelas 3, teman-teman sudah belajar yang namanya like and dislike. Saya suka makan, I love eating. Benar nggak? Ada ing-nya juga kan? Nah, ini bedanya karena activity, karena kegiatan. Jadi kita pakainya go. I go shopping every, gitu ya. I go swimming on. Nah, itu di belakangnya biasanya ada harinya. Atau kita gabungin sama si adverb of frequency tadi. Ini contohnya. Nanti teman-teman bisa baca lagi pelan-pelan, jadi bisa lebih ngerti. Nah, go verb ing. Kita lihat lagi ya videonya.
In this video, you're going to learn how to talk about activities that involve movement using the structure go plus verb and
okay, assalamualaikum grade 4, we meet again. Now we will continue to watch the video about go plus verb ing. Tadi sudah dibahas kalau go verb plus verb ing itu kita pakai untuk menjelaskan activity atau kegiatan kita. Kapan sih kita mau pakainya gitu ya?
In this video, you're going to learn how to talk about activities that involve movement using the structure go plus verb in ing. This is
jadi activity yang involve movement, activity yang melakukan gerakan.
The must know structure. Of course, I'm Jennifer from jforceenglish.com and this channel is dedicated to helping you sound like a fluent, confident, natural English speaker. Video. Let's talk about how to use the sentence structure go plus verb in ing. Now, this is a sentence structure that we use in very specific situations. And that one situation is when we're talking about an activity that involves physical movement. So a lot of these are just the physical activities that you do as leisure activities. Now, when we talk about these, we
katanya it is about the physical activity that you do as your leisure activity. Artinya kegiatan yang teman-teman lakukan pada saat waktu luang atau pada saat itu melakukan hobi kalian, ya.
Don't follow our basic English sentence structure, which is subject plus verb plus infinitive, which is to and verb. So for example, I don't say, I go to hike every Sunday. Go is our verb. And in the regular sentence structure, the following verb would be in the infinitive, which is what you see here. But this is incorrect. We need our gerund verb, which is simply a verb.
Di sini teman-teman bisa lihat katanya go plus to hike itu salah. Kenapa? Karena go itu udah kata kerja, hike itu juga kata kerja. Jadi nggak bisa tuh kata kerja sama kata kerja digabungin.
Alternative structure, an irregular sentence structure that we only use in specific cases. With verbs of physical activity and movement is one of those cases. So I need to say, I go hiking. I take my verb hike and I simply put it in the gerund form with ing. I go hiking every Sunday. That's the correct sentence structure. So just remember that this sentence structure is subject plus go plus gerund plus verb and ing. Now remember that go is our active verb and we're going to conjugate it according to the subject and the time reference. So when I say I go hiking every Sunday, that's my verb to go in the present simple conjugated with the subject I because I'm talking about a routine. But let's say my time reference is yesterday. It would be yesterday I went hiking. So remember, our active verb go.
Jadi sama ya, kalau kita pakainya yesterday tetap ada hiking, ada ing-nya. Go-nya kemana? Go-nya karena yesterday jadinya pakainya went. Oke? Jadi teman-teman cukup belajar sampai itu dulu. Karena kalau sudah masuk ke yesterday atau present continuous nanti bingung. Jadi intinya adalah go plus verb ing ini dipakai untuk menjelaskan kegiatan activity yang pakai movement, yang pakai gerakan. Oke, next ya. Contoh. Nah, go swimming, go shopping. Ini ada ya di punya teman-teman ya. Go fishing, go skating. Jadi pakai go sama verb ing. Oke. Skate itu kan verb, kata kerja, melakukan kegiatan. Ditambahin ing aja jadinya skating. E-nya dibuang. Jadi skat tambahin ing, skating. Misulis kalau go fishing, emang fish itu merupakan kata kerja. Fish bukannya ikan. Ikan kan kata benda, bisa dipegang. Oke, fish itu kalau di bahasa Inggris dia punya dua arti. Satu sebagai verb, sebagai kata kerja. Satu sebagai noun, sebagai kata benda. Fish bisa berarti ikan, bisa juga artinya mancing. Oke, jadi kita bisa pakai fishing sebagai verb, sebagai kegiatan. Ya. Oke, that's all about this lesson today. So, in your book you will see more. And thank you for today. Don't forget to stay healthy and keep eating good food, healthy food, and also keep exercise. See you soon. Bye. Assalamualaikum.